ASMR sportsman, oh, we're all good. It's Ollie here, as you know, probably anyway. I just want to do a very short video, probably be slightly longer than Conor McGregor versus Donald Cerrone. Which of you, how many of you paid to watch that pay-per-view? Like, I looked through the pay-per-view card, and it was the most average-looking card I've ever seen. In a long time. And yes, Conor was on there. Yes, Cowboy was on there. You had Anthony Pettis, Showtime Pettis. You had Holly Holm. I'm not interested in watching a Holly Holm fight. Showtime. Yeah, after he got took out by... Who did I see him lose to now? I want to say it was... Who was it? It was Nate, weren't it? Nate Diaz. Took out, you know, big time. So I'm not really interested in seeing Showtime again. But the Conor fight, that is what everyone paid for. And here in the UK, they were charging £20. Not £5. Not £10. Not £15. £20. £20. Now, I've made this mistake in the past. I've paid for Mayweather fight. I paid for Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather. I paid for lots of fights over the years. Ricky Hatton, Floyd Mayweather. And a few more on top of that. Unfortunately for people in America, from what I understand, you can get like the WWE Network, but the one called Fight Pass, I think it is. You can get it over here as well. And you get all the fights on there, but it's expensive, as far as I'm aware. Or you pay like $70 or $80 for a UFC card. Like every UFC card, I believe they have to pay for. That's what I've heard in the past, anyway. Correct me if I'm wrong. But here in the UK, it's £20, and I just couldn't justify it for a Conor McGregor fight, which I didn't see going very long. And it didn't go very long. It went 40 seconds. Yeah, it was an odd one. Like, in the past, Conor has made, obviously he's acted differently in the press conferences in the lead up to the fights. Think Khabib, think Jose, when he took his belt, Jose Aldo. They've been, you know, got in the face of everyone he's ever fought. Floyd Mayweather, the lot. Nate Diaz, he don't care, he gets in everyone's faces. This was a respectful Conor McGregor, all the way through. From when the fight was announced to getting in the octagon and touching club fists, you know, beforehand. Not doing his silly walk before to Donald Cerrone, which, you know, we always see him do. And within 40 seconds, the fight was done. Conor, you know, missed the first punch. And then he had 19 strikes after all of them connecting. They got into a clinch. He started hitting him with the shoulder, busted up Donald's face, like broke his nose straight away, I think. I mean, within 20 seconds of the fight, Cerrone walked back, separated from Conor, and already his eye had puffed up, just like we've seen against Tony, when he then blew down his nose, Cowboy did, and his eyes were completely shut. He couldn't open his eye. Then he had the head kick from over the top of the guard by Conor. You had I think there was a knee strike in there. And he got his Cowboy down on the octagon, on the mat. Conor was just raining in with punches. Like I said afterwards, he's now got stoppages at three different weight levels. Was featherweight, welterweight, and the other one, whichever the other weight class is that he's took it at. Did he deserve the win? Of course he did. I mean, what the hell did he deserve when I was just babbling there? People are saying that Cowboy threw, you know, he was basically paid to go down. No, he wasn't. I don't believe that for a second. Cowboy, you could not offer that man enough to go down like that. You gotta remember, for that, if he was gonna be paid to take a dive, you'd at least say, okay, we're gonna go a couple of rounds, make it exciting for the fans, and then have Conor stop you with a big head kick or something like that. There was no staging of this. This was just last night within them 40 seconds. There's been other fights he's been hurting, just in case you weren't it. I'm hoping he doesn't need the money anymore. He's got a really fun lifestyle that he loves to do. Paintballing, jet skiing, you name it, he does it. Deep sea diving. I hope he's in a position now where he can just step away, relax, and maybe do like open up his own MMA school or something like that. He's got his ranch where people come to train, so hopefully he can just enjoy, you know, being a dad, because he's a little boy. Dax, is it? Or Danger? I think it's Dax Danger Cerrone, something like that. I've heard it before. I've heard him talking about him on Joe Rogan. Conor, where does he go now? Well, afterwards you had Usman saying, look, I'm happy to take on Conor. George Masvidal has already said in an interview with Ariel Helwani, I believe it was, he said, look, the fight for me next isn't necessarily against Usman. The fight for me next is wherever the money is. Now, there's that attitude, and then Usman come out after the fight with Conor's fight, and Usman said, look, I ain't going for the money. I've got a title, I'll put it up against anybody. Masvidal was asked, would you put your BMF title up? And he said, look, I will do, as long as somebody else is putting something up as well. They said, well, what do you mean? He said, well, it could be money, it could be another title, but I'm not going to risk losing my BMF title just for a normal fight. I lose my belt, they lose nothing if I beat them. Conor doesn't have a belt. What he does have is probably the biggest drawing power in the UFC in terms of money. You will get paid if you fight him, and you know, the pay-per-view sales that they can do. And George talks a good game, Conor talks a good game. I don't think you'd get the respect Conor showed Donald. You will not get that respect going backwards towards George if George against Conor is signed off on. Conor apparently came out last night, I didn't see the full interview, and said, look, 2020 is coming, the season of Conor McGregor. You're going to see me 3 or 4 times. So I'm assuming that's like 3 more times after last night. And if we're being honest, Conor McGregor right now, I mean, we're on like this 17th of Jan, so like, you could easily sign him up for a fight middle of February, and it'd be ready to go 3 or 4 weeks from now, because he's done all his training camp. He will have knackered himself out more in a half hour training session leading up to his fight than he did in the 40 seconds that he was in there last night. He didn't take no damage in the slightest. Maybe he hurt his shoulder with them shoulder barges or nudges. But Conor could go again tomorrow or next week or next month. You could, if George is ready, you could sign that off. George Masvidal v Conor McGregor, middle of February. If you need a fight, there you go. Usman isn't ready yet. He was saying last night his thumb was broken in that fight with Colby. He said, you know, another 3 or 4 weeks, then I can start therapy on my thumb. But he did say, look, if the right fight come along, I'd be able to sacrifice more than just a hand. So maybe he'd go in with a dodgy hand, but that'd be silly. There'd be no point in doing that. Are George and Usman too big for Conor? That is the question. I wasn't overly fussed about Masvidal. I really wasn't. I seen the knockout of, I keep forgetting his name, frizzy haired, like Ben Askren. I seen the knockout of him. I was like, yeah, okay, that's a very lucky knee strike. I said, look, it was planned. But it's not like the fight went 5 rounds and he beat him. But then I watched George against Nate, and he absolutely destroyed Nate Diaz. Nate had a little bit of Nate came after and said, look, my plan was to drag it on to 5 rounds and finish him. And towards the end of the fight, he did look like Diaz was getting a bit more going his way. But ultimately, it was George's fight, and he did it for the BMF title. He really deserved to win it in the else is calling Conor out at the minute. I can't remember. They're the two names I've seen. I think if Colby hadn't lost to Usman, I think Colby Covington against Conor McGregor would have been a fight for the ages, just because of the back and forth, the press conferences and stuff you'd have had from them two would have been crackers. But don't get me wrong, and don't get it wrong, if you get Masvidal v Conor, there will be a lot of stick going on. Behind closed doors, there'd be a lot of respect as well. George isn't daft, but he's seen what Conor just did last night. Conor isn't daft, he's seen what George did tonight. I've recently read Michael Bisping's autobiography, and he said in there that, I can't remember who it was now, it was towards the end of his career, a fight he was having, not with Kelvin. Oh, who did he beat for the title now? Not Anderson Silva. The fight he had, you know, I can't remember. I'm gonna find out. I've literally finished reading it about a week ago. You're all screaming out, it was sound so, ain't you? Let's find out. Oh, it was Luke Rockhold. I got that wrong. It wasn't that fight I was on about. When he was taking on GSP, when Bisping was the champion, Mike the Count Bisping, yeah, he won the title for Luke Rockhold. He finally got the fight with GSP, and he was giving it so much aggro to George, like beforehand, like really winding him up, trying to get George to bite and to lose his calmness. And in all the press conferences, Mike was really winding George St. Pierre up. Then they ended up in a toilet together, a very small men's toilet. And as Mike said, like, he turned around all to his side, and there was George Masvidal. And not George Masvidal, so GSP. And GSP turned to him and said, "Hey, like, how you doing?" Like, the banter and the bad man attitude that Bisping had been shown just dropped. So, yeah, okay, let's have a chat. GSP said, "I noticed you driving or whatever, whatever car Bisping was driving." He says, "Yeah." George says, "Yeah, you want to get rid of that? They're rubbish. I used to have one always breaking down." And then they finished up, washed their hands. Bisping said, "Right, let's go back out there and put our bad man faces back on. Like, let's pretend we hate each other again." So that between Cowboy and Conor would have been genuine respect. When you get Masvidal v Conor, if we get it, there'll be nothing but hate. But when the cameras ain't rolling, they'll be decent to each other. Guaranteed. We'll all see that, though. Because what sells better? Being respectful. Being a twat. It's going to be being a twat every time. People like to see controversy. They like to see anger. They like to see, you know, genuine hate for each other. I mean, what are you going to believe more? That two people who hate each other are really going to put on a big fight? Or two people who really like each other are going to put on a big fight? You're going to go for the first, ain't you? I can't even think who else is calling out Conor right now. I mean, he apparently wants he's talking about doing a boxing match this year against Manny Pacquiao. Apparently his team are actually talking to Pacquiao's team or whatever about this fight. He wants to return to boxing. So, will we see Pacquiao maybe Masvidal, Usman all in the same year, as well as Cerrone? That'd be a crazy bloody year. The thing is with Conor, I think he must need the money now. My opinion, I know he's got a stupid amount of money, but he's also had a lot of trouble. He needs to sort out his persona after hitting that old man in the pub and whatnot. I think, like, Khabib, my mind went so blank then, guys. Khabib is the fight he wants. They were saying yesterday, I heard on ESPN or somewhere, the reason Conor is hanging around at that weight, had the fight against Cowboy and whatnot, is because he's hoping in April, when Khabib is taking on Tony Ferguson, and they've already tried to put this fight together like four times, I believe, four or five times, one of them misses weight or gets one of them to get injured. If Khabib gets injured or pulls out for whatever reason, he kind of can slip in there, beat Tony in it. In his mind, he'll do that anyway. And then with the rightful, charge it to Khabib. Or Tony gets injured or has to pull out for some reason, Conor slips in there, takes on Khabib in the rematch. So I guess we'll be looking at maybe George Masvidal, Khabib, and Manny Pacquiao this year. And if Conor was to lose one of them fights, the UFC, sorry guys, one of the UFC fights, it won't be the end of the world for Conor. Yeah, as long as he's making his money. He's taken losses before, lost to Nate Diaz, lost to Khabib, he's come back, won a fight each time. Come back and beat Nate in the second fight, come back and beat Donald Cerrone last night after 14 months out, or however long it was. So let's see what he does, let's see what